Couple of months back when Realme announced the Realme C3, everyone was impressed with its performance for the price of 7,000 rupees as it could handle games like PUBG decently well. Now fast forward to today, a lot has changed in between. GST has now gone up to 18% and we all know the conversion rate of dollar to INR. It has also gone up significantly. And that's the reason the price of C3 has also gone up to 9,000 rupees, which is understandable. But now Realme has no phone to offer in the price range of 7,000 to 9,000 rupees, I believe. So that's why they are launching the Realme C11, which comes with 2GB of RAM and 32GB of storage. And the price should be less than 9,000 rupees is what I'm expecting. And there should be no 3GB RAM variant. That is also something that I'm expecting, because if there is a 3GB RAM variant, then I feel people would go with the Realme C3 instead of this, because this one comes with G35. And that one comes with G70. And enough of specs now, let's quickly unbox the Realme C11 and take a look at it. My name is Saurabh Nahar, you're watching All About Technologies, let's begin. Starting with the unboxing, Realme C11 comes in the standard yellow box that we see with all the Realme smartphones. At the rear side, some specs are highlighted, such as it comes with 5000mAh battery, 6.5-inch HD display, 13-megapixel rear camera and Helio G35 processor. Now the MRP here is 8,999, but I'm sure it will be priced below that, so check out the description box. Anyways, opening up the box, first you are greeted with welcome to Realme family, and inside this you get the quick start guide and the warranty card. Next you get the smartphone itself, and to be honest, it looks really cool in this grey color, and I'll talk more about it in a bit. Power adapter included here is of 5V and 2A, which is kinda okay at this price point. And finally, you get a micro USB cable, which is sad as it's 2020 now. And finally, manufacturers should move to Type-C. Anyways, that's about it for the unboxing. Now let's take a look at the device. Starting with the build and design, the Realme C11 feels very well built. Now, even though it is mainly made out of plastic, but the materials used here feel really good for a phone that is priced under 9,000. Even in terms of design, I personally liked it. The design is much better than the plain plastic panels that we see with Samsung phones. And looking at the phone, no one could say that this is a sub 9,000 rupees phone. So good job Realme with the design and the build of this device. Now taking an overview of the device, at the bottom we have a single speaker at the right, micro USB port, microphone and a 3.5mm headphone jack. Moving on to the left, we have a SIM tray that accepts 2 SIM card and an SD card, so that's really nice. On the right is the volume control key and the power button. Now taking a look at the specs, Realme C11 comes with Helio G35 chipset, which has 8 Cortex A53 cores clocked up to 2.3 GHz, and GPU here is PowerVR GE8320. In terms of RAM and ROM, you get about 2GB of RAM and 32GB of storage. Now I don't know why Realme is calling it a gaming processor, as you can hardly play PUBG at smooth and medium graphics. And the experience is also not that great, which to be honest, I expected at this price point. But why they called it a gaming processor, I still don't understand. That said, you can play games like Asphalt 9 with some frame drops here and there. And you can also play Temple Run 2 without any problems. So basically, you can play some basic games on this phone. Now, in terms of day-to-day tasks, it performs decently well, as you would expect from a sub 9,000 rupees phone. With 3 to 4 basic apps running in the background, you will be able to multitask. But once you open a game along with 2 to 3 other applications, it will start to reload all the applications running in the background. So overall, don't expect too much in terms of performance and multitasking at this price point. Moving on to the display, it's a 6.5-inch 1600x720 resolution HD display. Now, what kind of glass is being used here on top of this display, I don't know. But apart from that, the viewing angles on this one are fine and even the brightness level is okay. So no complaints as of now. Output from the speaker is a bit low for my liking and I wish it was a bit louder. Coming onto the camera, there is a dual camera setup at the rear. The primary camera here is a 13 megapixel one with f2.2 aperture and the secondary one is a 2 megapixel one with f2.4 aperture. For selfie, there is a 5 megapixel camera on the front with f2.4 aperture. Now here are some of the samples that I have taken with the Realme C11 in this short time. So let me know what you feel about these samples in the comments section. Now before we wrap up, there are a few more things that I want to cover in this video. First, there is no fingerprint scanner on this device, which is fine. I feel because at this price point, you just can't expect all of the things. Second, the face unlock is present and it works decently in good lighting situations. Third and the last one is that this phone comes with 5000 mAh battery, which is amazing. But the charger included here is just 5V and 2A, so it might take more than 2 hours or around 2 hours to charge this device from 0 to 100%. But seriously, once again, I won't really complain at this particular price point. So guys, that was a quick unboxing of the Realme C11. Hope you guys found this video helpful. If you did, please do give this video a thumbs up. And guys, do share your thoughts about the Realme C11 in the comment section. Make sure to subscribe to the channel if you are not part of the AAD fam. Just subscribe to the channel and become a part of AAD fam. Make sure to follow me on Twitter and Instagram for more updates. And guys, if you are interested in buying this phone, then as always, link will be there in the description box. Well, that's pretty much it for this video. This is Saurabh Nahar. Thank you guys for watching. Bye.